one thing before we move on, a couple things that I saw. One, I saw a couple people going to the waist, so I just want to reinforce that we should not be going to our opponent's waist. After the World Championships or Olympics, Coach Zadik right now is the head coach, and then it was Coach Bruce Burnett in 2015, 2016. But Coach Zadik, he brings in all the world team members. When we get brought in, we look at all the film of our matches at the World Championships. And one thing, I did a couple matches, I went around the guy's waist instead of going through the guy's hamstring or his ankle, and I lost probably like 3 or 4 takedowns because of it. Because you can't keep the same type of pressure, right? We don't have both sides of his body anchored down, you know? So when I go to his waist here, immediately this guy's gonna stand up, and then he's gonna face me, so I'm not gonna be able to get the takedown. That happened to me a couple times. All right? So I don't want that to happen to you guys. So while we're doing this technique, while you go back home and work on it, make sure that when we're spinning behind, you put this elbow down, we spin behind either the ankle or the hamstring. Yeah, either one, ankle or hamstring. Yeah, it doesn't matter. And then we keep our hand on the top of his, our forearm on the top of his neck, back of his head. Another thing that I saw is people were releasing the hand from the chin and going to this arm drag here, and that's good. I've done that a couple times too. It's not a bad technique, and you guys can use it if you have a good feel for it. You know, I mean, wrestling people are different. There's so many different things that you guys can do. This is the stuff that works for me, but I feel like coming from the head, releasing the head to this back of his, to this arm drag here, back of his arm, I think it's difficult to keep pressure on top of him when I do this. All right, I think it's easier for him to get his butt away from me and circle back up. So a lot of people teach coming into that arm, dragging, and then trying to go behind him. But I think it's better if we just stay on top of the head. Release the pressure from the chin to go to the back of his head. So this time, we'll start in a quad pod. Guy will start in this position, so we don't have to push him anymore, at least right now. Guy's gonna start here, and then we're gonna bring our front leg, knee down to the mat, put pressure on his hands, and instead of being able to go behind the direction we went, we're gonna change directions. Because it's not always gonna, you can relax, yeah. It's not always gonna be, we put his elbow down and we spin behind and we get our points, right? Sometimes it'll work, but most likely guy's gonna react, and you're gonna have to be able to react as well and stay out in front of him. So this is a good way to do that. So he starts in his quad pod. I come down to my knee. I'm gonna put pressure on his elbow, and then I'm gonna try to circle behind this way. As I circle behind this way, he's gonna face me and try to keep his head in the middle of my chest. All right, that's what any good wrestler would try to do. It wouldn't let you get the angle. Maybe keep your head in the middle of your chest. As he faces me, I'm gonna use his momentum again. I'm gonna throw his head to the outside of my pec, and I'm gonna spin the opposite direction. So I spin here, he faces me. I throw his head in the opposite direction. My chest stays on top of his back. I grab the back of his armpit, back of his hamstring, and then again, driving through him. Put him down in the back. So this time, I want you guys to watch my right arm. Watch my arm that has his head. All right, watch my arm that has his head. Look at the way I throw it. I'm not throwing it completely away from me. Just a tiny throw to the outside of my pec. Here, down to my knee, elbow down, circle. Outside of my pec. Chest stays on top. Hand in the armpit, back of the hamstring. Now, watch my chest. You guys just watch my arm. Now watch my chest. On headlock, down to my knee, put that elbow to the back, circle. He faces me. What'd you guys notice about my chest? Stayed down, right? Pressure never released. Pressure stayed on my opponent. That's how I want you guys to work on it. When he circles, we keep our pressure down on top of his back. That way, there's no chance he can stand up and we lose these points. So again, one more time. I got my front headlock. I go down to my knee. I want to try and put this elbow to the mat. Circle. He faces me now. I'm here. Get our points. One thing that I always see when people are trying to do this technique is, as I see people try and go like this. But why would the guy face me from there? You know? We actually have to, we have to move our feet and try to get that angle. That's the only way that this is going to work. That's the only way you're going to get a reaction out of the guy that you're wrestling. So partner on bottom has to be a good partner and face you, but you also have to put forth the effort and actually try to spin behind him. That way, throw his head to the outside of your peg and run the other direction. Any questions? And then of course, if the guy doesn't face you, what do? Just go behind, right? Just go behind. Same thing. If guy doesn't pressure into you when you're pushing, we just push him out of bounds. All right, freestyle, it's a point. Folk style, they'll call stalling. It looks bad. So if the guy's not gonna react, we're just gonna do whatever you want with him. We'll spin behind him, we'll push him out. We'll use the techniques we already know. All right, let's give it a try. One, two.